Before we move to our considerations of SSIs, as we're meeting online today, it will be more challenging for members to indicate agreement to the items being discussed. I would therefore ask you to raise your hand if you are not content with the question being put, or if you wish to speak about an instrument. First item of business is consideration of an instrument subject to the made affirmative procedure. An issue has been raised on SSI 2021-470, the Public Health, Coronavirus, International Travel and Operator Liability, Scotland Amendment No. 13, Regulations 2021. The instrument is one of a series of instruments which amend the Health Protection, Coronavirus, International Travel and Operator Liability, Regulations 2021. Usual drafting practice requires that each amending instrument is, in a series, it should reflect the title of the principal regulations which it amends and include a number indicating the number of SSIs amending the principal instrument in that year. However, when referring to the principal regulations, the title of this instrument refers to public health rather than health protection. The Scottish Government has confirmed that this was an error. The next correctly designated instrument amending the Consolidated International Travel Regulations is also numbered number 13. The number and title of further amending instruments will therefore not accurately reflect the number of instruments which have amended these international travel regulations in 2021. The Scottish Government confirmed it does not propose to amend the citation provision in Regulation 1 of the instrument because that could cause further confusion. Instead, it will draw users' attention to the instrument in footnotes and subsequent instruments where appropriate. So does the committee agree to report the instrument under the general reporting ground in respect of a failure to follow proper drafting practice in the title of the instrument? Yeah. Thank you. And yes, Mr. Simpson?
Yeah, thanks, Convener. I mean, I agree with the recommendation here. However, it has to be said that this is very, very sloppy drafting practice. I mean, this sort of thing shouldn't be, it just shouldn't be happening. You need to get the title right, and it's all very well the Scottish Government saying they'll put something in footnotes, but, you know, that means that ordinary members of the public are going to frankly find this very, very difficult to follow. And it, you know, you shouldn't need legal training to have to follow regulations which are coming fast and furious at the moment, and maybe that is why we're seeing more and more mistakes like this, that legislation has been drawn up at pace. I am concerned at the checks and balances that have been put in place or have not been put in place. We just shouldn't be seeing mistakes like this, and I think it's probably worth a letter to the Scottish Government from the committee, just to highlight that we're not satisfied that this kind of error is being made.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Simpson. Just any other colleagues want to add anything? No. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Simpson, for your comments, and I do actually echo your comments, particularly regarding the clarity for the members of the public. I think genuinely anyone who's a lawyer will clearly be able to navigate their way around this type of situation. But for members of the public in what clearly is a fast moving situation, and regulations, we have obviously clearly seen a number of regulations in this area, and certainly for clarity for members of the public in particular, I would suggest that the Scottish Government need to improve on this. Now, this isn't common occurrence by any manner of means. This is the first time that this has happened, as we will all acknowledge. But certainly, I would agree that we should write to the Minister just to highlight our concerns. And also with that, does the committee wish to note the Scottish Government undertakes to clarify the anomaly in the instrument's title and footnotes to subsequent amending instruments? Okay. So no member has indicated other than comments thus far that they're not content or that wish to speak. So we are agreed on both points. Thank you. Under agenda item number two, we're considering instruments subject to the affirmative procedure. No points have been raised on the following draft instruments. The Scottish Government, sorry, Scottish Local Government Elections Amendment Order 2022. The Climate Change Nitrogen Balance Sheet, Scotland Regulations 2022. And the Maximum Number of Judges, Scotland Order 2022. Is the committee content with these instruments? Thank you. No member has indicated that they're not content or that we should speak, so we are agreed. Under agenda item number three, we're considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. An issue has been raised on SSI 2021-463, Red Rocks and Longay Urgent Marine Conservation number 2 order 2021. The instrument revokes and replaces the Red Rocks and Longay Urgent Marine Conservation Order 2021, SSI 2021-131, due to the extension of the boundary of the designated Red Rocks and Longay area of the Inner Sound of Skye Marine Protected Area. This instrument is to be brought into force urgently to further the stated conservation objectives for the Marine Protected Area, protect flapper skate and their eggs. It was made and laid before the Parliament on the 9th of December 2021 and came into force on the 16th of December 2021. Accordingly, it does not respect the requirement in section 28.2 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010 that at least 28 days should elapse between the laying of an instrument subject to the negative procedure and the coming into force of that instrument. In its letter to the presiding officer explaining the reason for why the 28-day rule not been complied with, the Scottish Government outlined that, following advice from Nature Scot, the extended marine protected area has been redesignated urgently and section 28.2 has been breached to remove the risk of further impacts on the flapper skate nursery area as soon as possible. Does the committee agree to report the instrument under reporting ground J on the basis that there has been a failure to lay the instrument in accordance with laying requirements under the interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010? And is the committee content with the Scottish Government's explanation provided for failure to comply with the laying requirements? But no member has indicated that they're not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Also, under this agenda item, no points have been raised on SSIs 2021-457. 461, 462, 466, 467, and 469. Is the committee content with these instruments? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Finally, under agenda item number four, we are considering instruments not subject to any parliamentary procedure. An issue has been raised on SSI 2021-452, the Act of Sederunt, Summary Applications, Statutory Applications and Appeals, etc. Rules 1999, and Sheriff Appeal Court Rules Amendment, Age of Criminal Responsibility, Scotland Act 2019-2021. This instrument amends the Act of Sederunt, Summary Applications, Statutory Applications and Appeals, etc. Rules 1999, and the Act of Sederunt Sheriff Appeal Court Rules 2015. Paragraph 3.2 and 3 insert new rules into the Sheriff Appeal Court Rules referring to an appeal under Section 38.3, 44.3 and 67.3 of the Age of Criminal Responsibility Scotland Act 2019. The committee identified an error with an inconsistency the cross-referencing in paragraph 3.2 and 3 of the instrument. In correspondence, the Lord President's private office explained that the reference to section 44.3 of the 2019 Act should instead be to section 46.3 of that Act, and it has committed to rectifying the error at the earliest appropriate opportunity. So does the committee agree to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on the general reporting ground in respect of this incorrect cross-reference? I do want to come in on a further point. And does the committee welcome that the Lord President's private office has committed to rectifying the error at the earliest appropriate opportunity? Okay, and with that, just one other point I would like to highlight. Clearly, with some of the information that we have received, it did strike me that the Lord President's office had suggested that they were acting urgently to the instrument that the Scottish Government brought in to change the age of criminal responsibility. Now, bearing in mind that the Act was passed in 2019. It strikes me that clearly there will have been communications between both the Scottish Government and the Lord President's private office in that period of time. So I would suggest that as a committee, they would write to both the Scottish Government and the Lord President's private office just to seek some clarity on the communications took place before the introduction of the instrument the Scottish Government brought forward, but also the situation that we have today. If the committee agreed with that. Okay, thank you. So, other than that additional item, no member has indicated that they're not content or that they also wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Also, under this agenda item, no points have been raised on S2021-456. Is the committee content with this instrument? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, so we are agreed. The next meeting of the committee will take place on Tuesday, the 11th of January 2022, which will include an evidence session on the committee's inquiry into the use of the made affirmative procedure during the pandemic with John Swinney MSP, the Deputy First Minister, and Cabinet Secretary for COVID recovery. And with that, before I do close the meeting, and move into private, I would like to wish all colleagues on the committee, all of our committee staff, but also anyone watching, a very Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I'd like to also to ensure that you all stay safe over the festive period. I look forward to working with you again in 2022, and it certainly has been a pleasure working with you this year as after the election win, also when I became the convener of the committee. So thank you very much for all of our work together. So with that, I'd like to close the meeting and move into private. Thank you.